Blockchain is evolving fast, and not all networks are built the same. Some are slow and expensive, some are fast but limited, and some are pushing the boundaries of what's possible. But which one's best? In this series, I'm breaking down XPR Network, Ripple XRP, and Ethereum to see how they compare across speed, fees, governance, and more. Which blockchain is the fastest? Which one has the best user experience? And which one's built for the future? Stick around as we go feature by feature, starting with human readable account names, one of the first things users notice when interacting with a blockchain. Let's dive in. Let's talk about something that seems small but makes a huge difference in how we use blockchain, human readable account names. If you've ever sent crypto, you know how stressful it can be checking and rechecking those long wallet addresses. Well, not all blockchains handle this the same way. Ethereum, like most EVM chains, uses long hexadecimal addresses, basically a random string of letters and numbers. It's fine for machines, but a nightmare for humans. If you make a typo, funds lost forever. To fix this, Ethereum users rely on ENS, Ethereum Name Service, but that's a separate system you have to set up and pay for. It's a whole thing. Ripple XRP has the same problem. It uses long hexadecimal addresses. There's no built-in solution for human readable names, meaning you need extra services or third-party tools to avoid making mistakes. Now, XPR Network does things differently. Instead of long, ugly addresses, XPR gives you a username, just like an email or a social media handle. Imagine sending funds to pool.xpr instead of some crazy string of numbers. It's built in, it's free, works out of the box, no extra setup, no extra cost, just easier transactions. This might seem small, but it's a game changer for everyday users. Sending crypto should be simple and safe. XPR Network is designed for real-world usability, while Ethereum and Ripple are still using decades-old address systems. Security in crypto is a big deal. One of the best ways to keep your funds safe is with a multi-sig wallet, which means multiple people or multiple keys have to approve transactions before they happen. But not all blockchains make it easy. Let's compare how XPR Network, Ripple, and Ethereum handle multi-sig wallets. First up, Ethereum. If you want a multi-sig wallet, you can't just create one. You need to deploy a custom smart contract using a service like Gnosis Safe. This means you pay gas fees to set it up, you trust a third-party contract to manage your funds, you need extra back-end services for managing transactions. And if you're not a developer, good luck. Multi-sig on Ethereum is powerful, but it's a lot of extra steps just to keep your funds secure. Ripple XRP does have multi-sig wallets, and they're built in, but there's a catch. It's extremely confusing for regular users. Centralized validators still control the network. Fewer customization options compared to Ethereum or XPR Network. So while it's easier than Ethereum, it's not as flexible for real world use cases. Now, XPR Network does things a little differently. Multisig is built in natively. No additional smart contracts required. You can set up multiple signers directly from the Explorer. It works just like a feature on an operating system, not a complicated extra step. This means any user or business can set up secure transactions instantly without needing developers, gas fees, or third-party services. If you're serious about security, multi-sig wallets are a must. On Ethereum, it's complicated and expensive. On Ripple, it's basic but limited. On XPR Network, it's native, easy, and designed for real-world use. That's why XPR feels more like a blockchain operating system, not just another crypto network. Imagine sending crypto and never worrying about gas fees. Sounds crazy, right? But that's exactly what XPR Network offers. Meanwhile, Ethereum charges gas fees for everything, and even Ripple has small costs. Let's break it down. Let's start with Ethereum. Every transaction, sending tokens, using DeFi, swapping assets, requires gas. Fees fluctuate based on network congestion, can range from a few cents to hundreds of dollars. High fees make small transactions unusable for everyday payments. Ethereum is powerful, but gas fees are a real barrier for mass adoption. Ripple XRP improves on this. Transactions cost around 0.2 cents, which is super low, but it's still not free. Every interaction requires some amount of XRP to cover costs. It's great for payments, but what if you need to run decentralized applications or dApps at scale? Even small fees add up. Now, let's talk about XPR Network. Instead of paying per transaction, users get free resources automatically. Developers can sponsor transactions for users, making dApps completely feeless. This makes XPR one of the only blockchains where users don't worry about fees. It's like having a blockchain with built-in gas credits. ensuring transactions always go through smoothly. At the end of the day, blockchains should be easy to use. Ethereum's gas fees make it expensive. Ripple is cheap, but it's not free. XPR Network is feeless by design, making it perfect for dApps, payments, and real-world adoption. When it comes to blockchain, speed matters. Nobody wants to wait minutes for a transaction to process, but not all blockchains are built for speed. Ethereum is powerful, but slow, processing only around 15 transactions per second. This is because every transaction is processed sequentially across all nodes. As more people use the network, it gets congested, leading to higher gas fees and longer wait times. Ethereum relies on layer 2 solutions like Arbitrum and Optimism to improve speed, but these add complexity. If you've ever waited minutes for a transaction, you know the pain. Ripple XRP is much faster than Ethereum, handling around 1500 TPS. It's designed for cross-border payments, so it processes transactions quickly, but XRP is not optimized for dApps or smart contracts, meaning its speed is mostly useful for payments and settlements. Great for moving money, but not flexible enough for full-scale blockchain applications. Now let's talk about XPR Network. This blockchain is built for speed. XPR Network handles over 4000 TPS, way more than Ethereum and Ripple. Transactions are processed asynchronously, meaning they don't have to wait in line. Actions happen in just 0.5 seconds, making it ideal for real-world applications, dApps, and high-frequency transactions. So whether you're sending tokens, running a decentralized app, or executing smart contracts, XPR Network is blazing fast. In the real world, speed is everything. Ethereum struggles under load. Ripple is fast, but limited to payments. XPR Network combines both speed and flexibility, making it the best choice for modern blockchain applications. Smart contracts are the backbone of blockchain applications, allowing us to build dApps, DeFi, NFTs, and more. But not all blockchains handle smart contracts the same way. Ethereum was the first major blockchain to introduce smart contracts, running on the Ethereum Virtual Machine, or EVM. Contracts are written in Solidity, which is widely used, but EVM is slow, optimized for security but not efficiency. Gas fees make executing contracts expensive, especially during high demand. And complex operations can take multiple blocks to process. Ethereum paved the way, but its limitations are clear. Ripple XRP was designed for payments, not smart contracts, but they introduced hooks as a lightweight alternative. Hooks allow basic transaction logic, just like converting tokens or enforcing limits, but they can't run full dApps or complex smart contract applications. It's a step forward for XRP, but not a full smart contract platform. Now, let's talk about XPR Network. Instead of using EVM, XPR runs smart contracts on WASM, or WebAssembly, which is faster than EVM, optimized for performance, supports multiple languages like C++, TypeScript, and more, not just Solidity. More efficient execution, meaning lower resource usage and better scalability. This makes XPR Network ideal for high-performance dApps, DeFi, and enterprise applications that need speed and flexibility. In the real world, not all smart contract platforms are created equal. Ethereum, EVM plus Solidity, is powerful but slow and expensive. Ripple with hooks is lightweight but too limited for real dApps. XPR Network with WASM is fast, efficient, and developer friendly, making it the best choice for scalable blockchain applications. Who controls the blockchain networks? Some blockchains give the power to their users, while others rely on a small group of decision makers. Let's break down how governance works on XPR Network, Ripple, and Ethereum. Ethereum is decentralized, but most of its governance happens off-chain. Upgrades and changes are proposed through Ethereum Improvement Proposals, or EIPs, which developers and stakeholders discuss off-chain. DAOs, or Decentralized Autonomous Organizations, allow projects to have governance, but these are not part of Ethereum itself. They're built on top of it. Decisions are often made by Ethereum's core developer community, not the average user. So while Ethereum is decentralized, its governance is mostly informal and happens outside of the blockchain. Ripple XRP takes a very different approach. It's not decentralized, as most decisions come from Ripple Labs. Validators don't vote on protocol changes like in a decentralized system. While XRP is a strong payments network, users don't control how the blockchain evolves. So in terms of governance, Ripple is completely centralized compared to Ethereum or XPR Network. Now let's talk about XPR Network. This is how blockchain governance should work. Every major change is voted on by token holders directly on the blockchain. It's transparent, decentralized, and built into the system. Unlike Ethereum, governance isn't just social consensus. Decisions can be automatically enforced through smart contract. This is what we call true on-chain governance, where users decide on the future of the network. In a decentralized world, how blockchains make decisions is critical. Ethereum relies on off-chain discussions in DAOs. Ripple is fully centralized. XPR Network gives power to its users with real on-chain voting. This is why XPR Network feels more like a decentralized operating system, not just another blockchain. Ever wonder how new cryptocurrencies are created? Not all blockchains make it easy. Some have built-in token creation, while others require custom smart contracts, which can be expensive and complicated. Ethereum is the king of tokenization, but creating a token here requires a smart contract. You need to write and deploy an ERC20 contract. This means you need a developer, and a single mistake in the code can lead to exploits. Deploying the contract costs gas fees, and interactions like transfers also require gas. Ethereum gave us token standards, but creating tokens here is not user-friendly. Ripple XRP has built-in token creation through XRP Ledger, or XRPL. No smart contracts needed, tokens can be issued directly. It's fast and efficient, but customization is limited. You can't build complex token logic like on Ethereum. It's great for simple tokens, but not ideal for advanced token economies. Now, let's talk about XPR Network, the best of both worlds. Like Ripple, it has built-in token creation, so no smart contracts needed. Unlike Ripple, it supports customization, making it powerful and scalable like Ethereum. Token creation is instant, free, and secured by default. So whether you're launching a utility token, governance token, or NFT, XPR Network makes it effortless. At the end of the day, token creation should be simple, fast, and secure. Ethereum requires coding and gas fees. Ripple is easy but lacks flexibility. XPR Network offers the best solution, instant token creation without custom smart contract risks. That's why XPR feels more like a decentralized operating system, not just another blockchain. Imagine using a decentralized app, or dApp, and never worrying about gas fees. Sounds impossible. Well, not all blockchains make dApp interactions easy. Let's start with Ethereum. Every time you use a dApp, whether it's swapping tokens, minting NFTs, or staking, you have to pay gas fees. Fees fluctuate based on network congestion. Costs can range from a few cents to hundreds of dollars. Users must always have Ethereum in their wallet to pay for transactions. This makes Ethereum expensive and frustrating for users and developers. Ripple XRP is better in terms of cost. Fees are very low, 0.2 of a dollar per transaction. It's fast and cheap, but still not feeless. If you want to interact with an XRP-based app, you must still hold XRP to pay for interactions. So, while it's cheaper than Ethereum, it doesn't fully solve the fee problem. Now, let's talk about the XPR network. Instead of paying for every transaction, dApps can sponsor user transactions using free resources. Users don't need to hold XPR to use an app. Transactions can be covered by the dApp itself. This creates a Web2-like experience for users while keeping the blockchain fully decentralized. By default, all users get a free account with enough resources to make transactions on the blockchain completely free. No friction, no gas fees, just smooth, feeless transactions. In the real world, gas fees are one of the biggest barriers to mass adoption. Ethereum always requires fees. Ripple, cheaper, but still not free. XPR Network, fully feeless for transfers and most interactions on chain. This is why XPR is more than just a blockchain, it's a decentralized operating system built for real world use. One of the biggest criticisms of blockchain technology? Energy consumption. Some blockchains use as much power as entire countries, while others are built to be green from the start. Ethereum started off using proof of work, which was incredibly energy intensive, similar to Bitcoin. In 2022, Ethereum moved to proof of stake, reducing its energy consumption by over 99%. But running Ethereum still requires validators who must stake ETH and run nodes. It's more efficient, but still uses a decent amount of power. So while Ethereum is greener than before, it's not the most energy efficient blockchain out there. Ripple XRP has always been energy efficient because it doesn't use mining. Instead of proof of work or proof of stake, Ripple relies on a federated consensus model where trusted validators approve transactions. This makes XRP transactions fast and low energy, but the trade-off? It's centralized. Only a small set of validators control the network. So while Ripple is low energy, it comes at the cost of decentralization. Now let's talk about XPR Network, designed to be both low energy and decentralized. Like Ripple, it doesn't require mining or staking, keeping energy consumption incredibly low. But unlike Ripple, XPR Network remains fully decentralized, using block producers to validate transactions without high energy costs, high speed, energy efficiency, and no environmental concerns. This makes XPR Network one of the most eco-friendly blockchains in the world. In the future, blockchains need to be scalable and sustainable. Ethereum, improved with proof of stake, but still moderate energy use. Ripple, energy efficient, but centralized. XPR Network, ultra low energy while keeping full decentralization. That's why XPR Network is built for the long term. Most people think of blockchains as just ledgers for transactions. But what if I told you that some blockchains work more like a decentralized operating system rather than just a settlement layer? Ethereum is great for DeFi, NFTs, and smart contracts. but at its core, it's still just a settlement layer. Transactions are finalized on Ethereum, but it relies on external apps and services for real functionality. You can't just run native applications. Everything needs to be deployed as a smart contract. Gas fees and scalability issues make Ethereum feel more like a global financial ledger than an actual operating system. Ethereum changed the game with smart contracts, but it's not built like an operating system. Ripple XRP is even more limited in this way. It's designed purely for payments. There's no real smart contract functionality aside from hooks, no built-in apps, no governance layer, just a high-speed financial network for moving money. So while XRP is great for payments, it's not built for decentralized applications. Now, let's talk about XPR Network, which functions more like a decentralized OS rather than just a blockchain. At-name accounts make blockchain feel more like a real user system. Built-in multi-sig wallets, no need for third-party apps, on-chain governance that works like a built-in update system, native token creation without custom smart contracts, feeless transactions and sponsored resources for dApps. It's not just a blockchain, it's a full-featured system for decentralized applications. Most blockchains are just digital ledgers. They record transactions but don't function like an actual operating system. Ethereum, a settlement layer for DeFi and smart contracts. Ripple, a fast payments network. XPR Network, a full-fledged decentralized operating system designed for speed, usability, and real-world applications. This is why XPR is so much more than just another blockchain. How long do you have to wait for a transaction to go through? Some blockchains take seconds, while others take minutes. Even longer if there's congestion. Ethereum's block time is around 12 seconds per block, which means transactions aren't instant. Depending on network congestion, you might wait 30 seconds to several minutes for a confirmation. If you're paying a low gas fee, your transaction can get stuck waiting for miners or validators to prioritize it. And for finality, it can take several minutes or even hours for deep confirmation security. Ethereum is faster than Bitcoin, but it's still too slow for instant transactions. Ripple XRP is much faster than Ethereum because of its consensus mechanism. Block time is around 3 to 5 seconds, meaning transactions confirm almost instantly. There's no waiting for gas fees to determine priority, so transactions settle quickly and predictably. But since Ripple focuses on payments, this speed doesn't apply to complex smart contract execution. Great for moving money fast, but not a full blockchain ecosystem. Now, let's talk about XPR Network, where speed is a priority. Multiple actions can be executed in 0.5 seconds, faster than Ripple and way ahead of Ethereum. Transactions don't wait in a queue, they're processed asynchronously, so there's no congestion or long wait times. It's so fast, in fact, MetalX, the native DEX on XPR Network, has a full order book trading mechanism that works entirely on-chain. No centralized off-chain JavaScript logic here. This makes XPR perfect for decentralized applications, DeFi, and real-world payments that need instant execution. In a world where speed matters, block time is everything. Ethereum? 12 seconds per block, but it can take longer with congestion. Ripple? 3 to 5 seconds, faster payments but limited functionality. XPR Network? Blazing fast 0.5 second blocks, perfect for high-speed applications. That's why XPR Network is one of the fastest, most efficient blockchains on the market today. When you look at every major category, XPR Network comes out ahead. Ethereum, powerful but slow, expensive and relies on layer 2. Ripple, fast and low fee, but limited to payments and kind of centralized. XPR Network, fast, scalable, feeless, decentralized, and built for the future. So what do you think? Did XPR Network win this comparison? Let me know in the comments, and if you enjoyed this deep dive, like, follow, and subscribe for more.